Okay, so the next bit, that's all the packages installed apart from the kernel. The next bit about debugging symbols, some of the programs will have debugging symbols embedded in them, and by stripping, we can make the system smaller and possibly run quicker as the packages will be, or the binaries will be smaller. Is optional, as it says there. The system size can be reduced by 2 gigabytes, so let's see how much space the root is taking at the moment. So just under 7 gigabytes in total. So in theory, should we be able to get that down to about 5 gigabytes? It explains what it does there. The symbols are needed if you're running regression tests with Valgrind or GDB later in BLFS. The strip will overwrite the binary or library file it is processing. This can crash processes using code or data from the file. If the process running strip is affected, the binary or library being stripped can be destroyed. This can make the system completely unstable. To avoid this problem, we copy some libraries and binaries in the temp, strip them there, and then reinstall them with the install command. Now, I have done this before and had this problem that's been described here just trash the everything that I've done so far. So what I tend to do if I do this is to take a backup of the system. You can do that in a couple of ways. You could use tar to back up the files. What I prefer to do is to take a disk image, which is a bit more long-winded, but it's far safer than taking an archive of the files, in case, maybe the archive might miss hard links, something like that, if you've not used the correct options. It does also mean you've got to come out the chroot, you've got to unmount all the file systems. So I think I'm going to do that. I don't particularly want to trash that. I'll show you what I do. So first off, I've got to come out of the chroot with Control D. I then need to unmount all the virtual file systems. So it's basically all of these systems here. So probably what the quickest thing to do is to unmount recursively everything under LFS. So if I do mount again, you see the last mount point is temp fs. So now I need to remount the no, actually I don't need to remount anything. Because I've got everything unmounted, I can safely take a copy of the disk that Linux is on. So it does look like, oh, that's interesting. When I do fdisk, oh, okay, I was getting muddled up. I forget this red message, this warning, it always applies to the device below it. Because there's no space between the preceding device and the message itself, I always get lost thinking it's associated with the device above it. It's not, it's associated with the device below. So it's obviously some, maybe it's the way that Rufus has written the Gen 2 image, because I don't normally see that at all. It's obviously not written it completely correctly or in a compatible way. If I do fdisk -l slash dev slash sdb, you'll see there is the message right at the very top. So yes, as you saw with SDA, there's no problem at all. So what I do also need is somewhere to store the image. So I happen to have another storage device here, which I've just plugged in. So when it's initialized, yep, there it is, it's appeared. If I I do fdisk minus l, you can see I've got this drive here. It's actually a live system already, so I've got to be careful that I don't actually trash anything off on there. So all I need to do now is I need to mount that system so I can actually write files to it. So I'm going to make another directory under the mount directory and call it, say, DST for destination. I'm going to mount the partition that I'm going to store this image on onto that mount point. And if I do df minus h, just to check the space, I've got 800 gigabytes there, so that's fine. The hard disk I'm copying from is half a gigabyte. So as raw data, it would fit directly on there, but because I've plugged this into USB 2, what I'm going to do is just use gzip to compress it minimally so it doesn't take any extra time doing compressing. But in theory, because it's compressing the data, there's less data to copy across the USB. It should be a little bit quicker because of that. So I'll time this to see how long this takes. It shouldn't take more than a couple of hours or so. And what I need to do is I'll use DD to read. So the in file is going to be /dev/sda. I want to read all of the disk, so it includes all the partition data and the boot sector and so on. And I'll set a block size of 64k, so it's a reasonable size for it to work with. I'm going to send that to, I'll do status equals progress, so I'll know how much of the disk it's done. I'm going to pipe all that information through gzip, compress it with the lowest compression ratio, and then pipe that back out into DD and send it to an output file on MNT DST and call it, for example, LFS 12.0 demo. And it's a disk, so I suffix that with .disk so I know it's a complete disk. And because it's a gzipped file, I'm going to add on gzip. So normally, you'd probably do something and then gzip it afterwards and gzip adds the gz on. Because I'm doing the reading and compression all in one go using the streams, I need to manually add GZ onto the end of my file name. So that should be it. So just to recap, I'm using DD to read from the device using 64k blocks. I'm going to output the progress of the read. Everything that it reads is going to be put through GZIP, which will compress it with a minimal compression, minus 1. GZIP's got minus 1 through to minus 9, and minus 9 is the best compression but also takes longer. That compressed data will be sent to DD again, a different instance of DD, and it will send that output to that file, which of course will be the compressed version of the whole of the LFS disk. So I'll start that running now and come back when it's finished. Okay, so that's finished after 74 minutes, so it's not too bad. An hour and a quarter. Right, that's the config file, so there is the disk image. So if everything does go badly wrong, I can restore that. So 42 gigabytes. So first thing I'm going to do is unmount that disk. And I'll unplug it as well. And then I've got to remount the root partition that we're building Linux from scratch on back at LFS. And then I've got to go back and go through the process of mounting the virtual kernel file systems. And finally enter the chroot. Let's see if that's still, yep, that's still there. So now I should be able to carry on doing the stripping. So it says important, if there's any package whose version is different from the version specified in the book, either by following a security advisor or satisfying personal preference, it may be necessary to update the library file name in Save User Lib or Online User Lib. Failing to do so may render the system completely unusable. So first we're going to create this environment variable with these libraries by the looks of it, and that's why it mentions about the versions, because you can see there's versioning in those file names. CD user lib, and this is one of the commands where the files are stripped, moved to temp and stripped, and then moved back again. And again, creating a couple more environment variables with specific files and libraries. Stripping once for the binaries and once for the libraries, and then by the looks of it, processing all the remaining binaries and libraries that haven't been stripped. That's done, so the last thing to do is to unset all the environment variables that have been set, and that's it. So let's now go to the next page, cleaning up. We can remove some temporary files. Let's see what the disk usage is. So yeah, we've gone down to 4.7, so that is about 2 gigabytes. So just tidying up a few odds and sods here now. Any LA files that are left, the libarchive files, can be removed. The compiler built in 6 and 7, chapter 6 and 7, is not needed anymore, so that can be removed as well. And finally, the test user can be removed. So that, don't worry about that message. That's just because we set the setting to not create the spool directory, I think it is, or file, I can't remember now. So that's why that error has come up, because it wasn't created in the first place. So that, yeah, that looks like it's about another 100 megabytes that was deleted just then.░ װ     װ└     װ││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││').װ└².².==![││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││></││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││││></².².².².².².².².².².př![     װװ     װ││││││││││││││││││││││││